Good afternoon, students. Today our topic is glycolysis. It is very, very important very fast question. Next, in previous class I will explain what is respiration. How many types of respiration is present in the lung? In aerobic respiration, four steps are present. The first step is glycolysis. It is also called EMB cycle. So what is glycolysis? Glyco means glucose. Glycis means splitting. So glyco means glucose, glycis means split. Okay? And the glycolysis is discovered by three scientists. They are Kempain, Meyerhoff and Farran. That's right. Glycolysis is also called EMB cycle. E for Kempain, M for Farran, Meyerhoff, C for Farran. Kempain, Meyerhoff, Farran. That is EMB cycle. Next. Glycolysis takes place cytoplasm of cell. So, in each living organism cell, glycolysis will be take place. And it is common in aerobic and anaerobic respiration. So, glycolysis takes place both type of respiration, that is aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. So, next, in glycolysis, one glucose molecule converts into two molecules of pyruvic acid. One glucose molecule converts into two molecules of pyruvic acid. The end product in glycolysis, the end product is pyruvic acid. Next, it is common, glycolysis is common in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So glycolysis, it will be taken place in prokaryotic organisms and eukaryotic organisms. So glycolysis is completed in 10 reactions. How many reactions? 10 reactions. They are first one, phosphorylation, second one, isomerization, third one, phosphorylation, fourth one, cleavage, fifth one, isomerization, sixth one, oxidation, seventh one, dephosphorylation, eighth one, shift reaction, ninth one, dehydration, tenth one, dephosphorylation. Total 10 reactions. So glycolysis complete 10 reaction or glycolysis complete with 10 reaction. So here you see first and third reactions are phosphorylation and 7 and 10 reactions are dephosphorylation. 7 and 10 is the dephosphorylation and 1 and 3 is the phosphorylation. Okay? Okay, first reaction, phosphorylation. First reaction is phosphorylation. In glycolysis, glucose is reacted to ATP. One glucose molecule reacted to one ATP, convert into glucose 6 phosphate. Glucose 6 phosphate in the presence of kinase enzyme. Which is then kinase enzyme. So you can remember in a reaction ATP appears before reaction or after reaction. Only the enzyme which is involved in kinase. Kinase enzyme uses in this reaction. If ATP appears in a reaction mostly. Kinase enzyme. glucokinase from tyrosine kinase. First reaction, phosphorylation. Glucose molecule reacts with ATP, converts into glucose 6 phosphate in the presence of kinase A. In this reaction, what ATP molecule uses? So, first reaction, ATP uses. Yes. Remember, if ATP appears in any reaction, the name is kinase. Next. Second reaction. Isomerization. Glucose 6 phosphate converts into fructose 6 phosphate in the presence of isomerase enzyme. Glucose 6 phosphate converts into fructose 6 phosphate in the presence of isomerase enzyme. In isomerization reaction, only isomerase enzyme will be used mostly. So mostly isomerase enzyme is appear in isomerization reaction. Next. Third reaction, phosphorylation. Fructose 6 phosphate reacts into ATP, converts into fructose 1,6 phosphate. So in third reaction, phosphorylation, fructose 6 phosphate reacts into ATP molecule, converts into fructose 1,6 bisphosphate. In third reaction also, what ATP utilizes? What ATP utilizes in third reaction? And the enzyme is kinase, same enzyme. So total how many ATP are utilized? Two. One in first reaction, another one in third reaction. You can remember, in a reaction, the endotherapy is first product, first compound in next reaction. A reaction means your last or the next reaction means only first half. So, don't confuse about the reaction. Okay, write about it. Okay, fourth reaction. Fructose 1,6 bisphosphate, which is formed in the phosphorylation reaction, it is divided into two compounds. They are glycerinate triphosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Glycerinate triphosphate. G3P. Glycerinate triphosphate. And DHAP, dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So, fructose 1,6 bisphosphate, it is a 6 carbon compound. G3P is 3 carbon compound, and DHAP also 3 carbon compound. So, 6 carbon fructose 1,6 bisphosphate is divided into two triose carbons compounds. They are glycerinate triphosphate, GTP, and dihydroxyacetone phosphate, DHAP. So, this reaction takes place in the presence of aldolase enzyme. Next, here how many GTP are formed? One. Okay. Next. Fifth reaction, isomerization. DHAP, which is part of the previous reaction, it is did not participate in any other reaction. So, it is converted into G3P, glycerinate triphosphate, in the presence of isomerase enzyme. So, DHAP is converted into G3P in the presence of isomerase enzyme. Here, how many G3P are formed? One. In fourth reaction, 1. In fifth reaction, 1. Total 2 G3Ps. 2 molecules of G3P formed in glycolysis. Each G3P contains 3 carbons. So both are similar. the image reaction G3P and isomerization reaction G3P. Both are similar and they participate in the same reaction. The reactions are same. So that's why I will write only one G3P reaction. But you can understand and you can increase always double. Example, one G3P is involved in the next reaction. I will write only one G3P. You can understand two G3Ps. Okay. Next, sixth reaction. Oxidation. Glycerin 3 phosphate react with NAD plus and H3PO4. Phosphate, inorganic phosphate. Convert into 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid. 1,3 BPGA. 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid. In the presence of dehydrogenase NJ. In this reaction, one NADH also formed. So here, how many G3P involved are participated? One. But total two. Because we have two G3P. That's why from one G3P, one NADH2 is formed. So we have two G3P, two glycerylate, three phosphate. So two NADH2 form total. So I was writing only one G3P, but you can understand two G3P. Why? Because we have two G3P. Okay, right. Okay, seventh reaction. D phosphorylation. 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid reacts with ADP, convert into 3 phosphoglyceric acid. BPGA, 3 phosphoglyceric acid. In this reaction, one ATP molecule releases. One ATP molecule will be formed. Here, which enzyme is appear in this reaction? ATP will be present in the reaction. So the enzyme is kinase. 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid react with ADP, convert into 3 phosphoglyceric acid in the presence of kinase enzyme. So one ATP molecule formed in this reaction. So from 1 G3P, that means in the 6th reaction, 1,3 BPG is formed. So there are 1,3 BPG is formed. 2 molecules of 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid is formed. So 1 ATP formed from 1,3 BPG, but we have 2 molecules. So in this reaction, 2 ATPs are formed. Next, shift reaction. 3 phosphoglyceric acid convert into 2 phosphoglyceric acid in the presence of mutase NJ. Next, dehydration. 2 phosphoglyceric acid convert into phosphoenol pyruvic acid. PEP. Phosphoenol pyruvic acid in the presence of enolase NJ. In this reaction, one water molecule released. But total two water molecules. Because double. I already explained why double. Because we have two G3Ps. Two G3P formed in the glycolysis. In glycolysis. So here one, but total two water molecules. Here one ATP, but total two ATP. Okay, right. Okay, last reaction, that is chain reaction, the phosphorylation. PET, phosphoenolpyruvic acid, which is formed in the ninth reaction, it is converted into pyruvic acid. In the presence of which enzyme? Kinase, why? Because ATP is here. Phosphoenolpyruvic acid reacted with ATP, ADP converted into pyruvic acid in the presence of kinase enzyme. In this reaction, one ATP molecule is formed, but total 2 ATP will be formed. In glycolysis, what is the ratio? What is the end product? Pyruvic acid. It is 3 carbon. Carbon. Conclusion about the glycolysis. In glycolysis, one glucose molecule is converted into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. Two molecules of pyruvic acid. Glucose molecule contain 6 carbons. Each pyruvic acid contain 3 carbons. Next, how many ATPs are found in glycolysis? 4 ATPs are found. In which reaction? 7 and 10 reactions. In 7 reaction, 2 ATPs are found. 10th reaction, 2 ATP is formed. And how many NADH2 are formed? 2 NADH2 forming 6th reaction, that is oxidation reaction. How many water molecules are released? 2 water molecules. In which reaction? 9th reaction, that is dehydration reaction. How many pyruvic acids are formed? 2 pyruvic acids. In which reaction? 10th reaction. How many ATPs are used? 2 ATPs. In which reaction? 1 and 3 reaction. In 1, first reaction, first phosphorylation. 1 ATP used. Third reaction, that is second phosphorylation. Second ATP used. How many ATPs are formed? 4. How many ATPs are used? 2. So, you can remove 2 ATPs from 4 ATPs. What is the balance of ATP? 2 ATP. Net balance. Next. So, don't confuse how they are formed, how 4 ATPs are formed. If you are confused, I will explain once again. In cleavage reaction, fructose 1,6 bisphosphate divided in cleavage reaction, fructose 1,6 bisphosphate divided into two compounds, that is the GGP and DHA. So DHAP is not participated in any other reaction, that's why it is converted into glycerolate triphosphate, G3P. From this G3P, it is the first G3P and it is the second G3P. From this first G3P, 2 ATPs and 1 NADH2 and 1 water molecule and 1 pyruvic acid is formed. From this G3P, 2 ATP, 1 NADH2, 1 water molecule and 1 pyruvic acid is formed. So, each G3P gives 2 ATP, 1 NADH2, 1 water and 1 pyruvic acid. So, that's why 2 plus 2, 4 ATPs. 1 NADH2 and 1 NADH2. 2 NADH2, 1 water molecule and another water molecule. 2 water molecule, 1 pyruvic acid and another pyruvic acid. Total 2 pyruvic acids. Finally, in glycolysis, 1 glucose molecule is divided into two molecules of pyruvic acid. So the reactions are very simple. You can practice the reaction 2 to 3 times. And don't by heart the reactions. You can follow the traits. Which enzyme is involved in which reaction? I already explained. Okay? Note.